Grand Rising, Kings and Queens. I call you guys Kings and Queens because if you're on this channel, we put the class in class-based shooter. Me, I consider myself the king, your boy Android Centaur 5, and we are back with another video for this great game called Payday 3. And today, conveniently, they put out the new blog update number 7. And it just so happens to correlate into the video I was going to put out. Well, I was actually going to put this one out after the one I was going to do. I was actually going to do a sniper video next. But conveniently, since they put out this blog, it actually works out with the video that I was going to do next after the sniper anyway. So let's just, change courses. All right, this blog is about the, you guys can see it right there, the new shock grenade. So we're going to be doing the updated Bombardier video. We're going to go ahead and look over this blog. We're not going to go through the whole thing. We're just going to kind of skim it. There it is in all its glory. Now, this name, I don't know why they, I mean, I know why they went with this name, but come on now. To Swedish and Norwegian people, this was probably clever. But to Americans, they're going to look pig tickler. It's not going to mean cop. I don't know if this is a great name. They might need to change that name. Pig Tickler is probably not the best thing to look at. But before we go into the blog and see what everything is, we're gonna go ahead and look at the little clip that they put up on the TikTok to about this particular blog. Let's go ahead and take a look at it here real quick, y'all. See what happens.
All right, we're at the Starbreeze office, and today we're going to be taking a look at what some of our developers have been working on. Let's go.
Hey, Alex.
Yo.
What do you at Starbreeze?
I make guns.
Are you working on something cool?
I'm working on a new throwable.
Can we see?
Sure, go ahead. Just some early stuff.
All right, y'all. When y'all look at that, does that look like it's going to be a shock grenade? I swear to God, I thought it was going to be like an incendiary explosive device or something. I thought it was going to be like, I don't know, a time-based fire starter of some sort. I mean, because look, like once he does the rendering of it, it looks like the top of a lighter or something. Like, look at this.
That looks cool. Let's get in there.
You gonna tell me that doesn't look like the top of a lighter? Come on, I was not thinking shock grenade. That I don't even know what part of the actual grenade that is. I mean, like, look at that, and then look at this. That what is that? Where did that look like that at? It does. It looks. What is that? Like, I don't know, y'all. I don't know. That was kind of weird. But either way, that is the Pig Tickler M187. Okay, I know we all know the code 187 means murder, but Pig Tickler M Murderer? Who put this name together? The name is just crazy, bro. All right, now, what did I tell y'all with the last update that I was talking about? I told you this is not a armor meta like the YouTubers try to get you to believe. I told you this game was crowd control. Look at that. They're adding to everything I'm saying. Crowd control. This particular grenade is for crowd control because the game's meta is actually crowd control. Y'all really need to go take a look at my last two videos I just put up. Kind of funny that this is the next throwable that they're putting into the game, considering that my last debuff video would work perfectly for this, but we just so happen to be doing the bomb video. By the way, this video might be a little bit long because I'm putting this together with the bomb video. I'm putting it all in one, so it might be a little bit longer. So I'll probably put timestamps in it so you guys can skip to where you want to go. I'm rambling. Let's just go ahead and push through. All right, so this new device, the Pig Tickler 187. Why didn't they put the M in here? Like, they didn't proofread this. Anyway. It's a cool new thing for your arsenal, blah, blah, blah. It's a grenade that throws, when you throw it, it explodes 3 times before it expires. And any enemies within those 3 explosions will become stunned for 1 second. Is it only 1 second? I feel like it should be like 3 seconds at least, or two. I don't know. 1 second seems too quick. Anyway, they become stunned before it expires. And then after the stun, it slows them for 3 seconds. So I guess totally is, technically it's 4 seconds of crowd control. The slow and the stun. Okay, I guess that's kind of cool. We didn't want this one to be a glorified flashbang, So it has different features in it to make it, you know, stand out from the flashbang. And then initially, it says enemies or civilians. So is this going to be like the electric battery on the zappers where you can shock your hostages and then they have a chance to get up and run away? Because sometimes they go back down and they tie themselves up again, and sometimes they don't. And then they just get up and walk away mid-wave. I hope it's not like that, but if it is, that would kind of be a downside to it. It pretty much, when they throw it on the ground, it blows up three times, and then it shocks or makes chain lightning to seven different people, which could go around a corner as well. I guess that's cool. I mean, that's pretty cool. The grenade itself doesn't really do any damage, but to some law enforcement are more conductive than others. Like, it instantly kills chilled zappers and techies. Okay, all right, so I get the zappers and the techies. Why does it do shields? What do shields have to do with conduction at all? I mean, that's good. I'm not mad about that, because the shields be real annoying unless you're using something that has a bunch of recoil, like automatic, like a shotgun shield is. It's a headache. But for all of the pretty much the single target ones that you can control the recoil on, you make quick work of the shields. But I guess that's real cool. Sadly, it just still doesn't do anything to the dozers, though. I like that, though. Like, I don't ever want to be overpowered on the game. I still want a chance that I could possibly lose. And I feel like this is a good mixture. That name, horrible. They should get rid of that name. But as far as the shock aspect to it, it's a cool mechanic. I really would have liked incendiary rounds better, like Molotovs or something. But, you know, this is cool. Hey, put down in the comments, y'all. Have they ever had, like, a shock grenade like this on Payday 2? Because I'm guessing they just are trying to go with anything that's not Payday 2. They want all new ideas. So I'm guessing they're not going to just reskin Payday 2 items. But if I'm wrong, someone pin that down in the comments. But anyway, moving on. Here's a gift of how it looks. All right, so you throw it out. It looks kind of like a smoke grenade. And yeah, okay, you see it went to the hostage on the ground first, and then from the hostage to the SWAT guy. And then when the other SWAT guy got close, it chained over to him too. I thought it was going to chain off of their bodies, though. That looked like it went off of the SWAT guy. And wasn't it supposed to go up to seven people? There were other people there. Why didn't it go over there? But then again, this is the development, so maybe, you know. I think that lightning could be better, too. It doesn't look like it chains very well. Imagine putting this together with a kinetic short circuit. You would stop everything. Oh, that would be broken. Maybe I should... Oh, this grenade should go with the human shield build that I have. But anyway, yeah, we're going to get past this and go straight into the rest of the video. I just really wanted to take a look at this and be able to use that as a thumbnail. And like I said, all of these items will be in the build that we're about to display right now anyway. So technically, this could work very well. I told you guys, there's build variety in this game. You don't have to do only armor, and you definitely should be putting a focus on your build, a theme to your build. You really shouldn't be doing that that mix everything up. Jack of all trades, my build does a little bit of this, my build does a little bit of that, because then you don't get the full effect or value off of any build that you actually try to put together. But without further ado, we're going to go ahead and jump into the loadout. And like I said, we're not going to do the normal little gameplay in the beginning of it, then we're just gonna jump right into it because this is already going really long. Let's jump into the loadout of the updated Bombardier build. Let's go. Bombardier build. Like I said, I didn't change any of this stuff. I feel like this stuff all held up pretty well, and I'll go ahead and go through it with you. I did change up the look of Wolf now. Instead of having the white mask baseball helmet, we went with the burnt baseball helmet with the burnt orange leather hoodie leather coat combo. We're keeping the scar, We did add the little charm for the football helmet, and whenever we get Wolf's sticker again, or they figure out why my stickers are deleting, I'll put the Wolf sticker back on it. And I got the blue and orange gloves to match the ensemble. And then I put the square sight on it, even though that's not the best sight for this one, but I'll put the square sight on it so I can match the brick squared off. What is this? Is this a Signature 40? Yeah, it's a Signature 40. Okay, well, let's go ahead and take a better look at that Signature 40. I really like the way this one looks. I think this was the first gun that I actually bought. But I like the way it looks. It works really well for what he has to do. And since that one had the box scope on it, that one's actually a dot. I actually didn't know that. Well, since that one has the red dot box scope on it, I thought it was only right to do the same thing with this one, which we can take a look at. Does that one have a box too? I can't tell. Hold on, wait. I know there's a way you can see. Oh, okay. Yeah, see, that one's not a box. That one's a circle. I guess it's just because it's a little bit bigger. Anyway, there's the football helmet, which looks pretty cool. I like the way this one came together. These are the mods that I put on it. I'm not going to go through all of them because these are old. They didn't really change. The recoil, I pretty much boosted up the recoil because this thing's recoil is crazy. Out of all the assault rifles, this one does have the highest base damage. But unfortunately, this is not my favorite assault rifle. I just thought it went really well with this particular build. Anyway, this is the SCAR, the Signature 40. Like I said, you need the ammo bag for this grenade build. It's pretty much endless grenades. You never run out of grenades. And you actually need the ammo bag to make that happen. We're definitely going with the frags because this is a bombardier build. We're going heavy ballistics. I actually really wanted to do the lighter ones, but there is a chance that you do blow yourself up with this build if you're not careful and actually doing the build as you should, which I'll demonstrate. So just in case you take any damage at all, you don't want to be one shot by your own grenades. So I went with the heavy ballistic, and I don't know why that one's on there. That didn't make any sense. It was supposed to be the grenade launcher for obvious reasons. We're blowing things up, clearly. Infrasonic mines, just because, yeah, duh. Pretty much. It's not much to this loadout. It's pretty simple. You can actually use any primary that you want, any secondary that you want, because this really isn't about the guns for this build. It's just all about the grenades. So without further ado, let's go ahead and jump into the skills. Let's go. Okay, and we're here with the skills. Like I said, a lot of this didn't change. We kind of just added in the 7 points where we were missing them. But it definitely made this a way more complete build. Before, when I was doing this, it was good. It worked. But you did have a risk of dying a lot with this one. Now, with the extra 7 points, I 1000% believe that you can take this into Overkill and do the kiss the chef challenge, and it's no different than having a gun. You're just using grenades as your primary source of damage instead of your gun. Just watch where you throw your grenades so you don't kill your hostages. That's pretty much it. But we're gonna go ahead and go through the build as quickly as possible so we can jump right into the gameplay, which is where this whole video will really shine and be brung together. But we're gonna go ahead and start with the ammo specialist, and then we're going into scrounger. These two, like I said, this makes it so you have endless grenades and that you always have a throwable at all times. You never run out. This is the heart of this build. 1000%. Then we're going with the fully loaded because we're carrying the ammo bag clearly, and we want to, you know, even when we run out of picking up all of the ammo stuff, which gives us extra damage when we pick them up, it's you still won't run out because of these two. It just makes it more convenient to pick it up by the bag that's right next to you instead of having to run out and get the ammo to pick them up. This one, we're doing plate up, but really, no, we're not. I really still feel like this is better. I mean, I don't know, because I don't really know if that percentage works for the grenade damage or is that percentage works just for when you're shooting. That'd be a good reason to have the damage numbers pop up so you can see the difference. But until then, I guess I'll just leave it like this. That's the reason I left it off before, but I really kind of want to put that on just because we're reaching out of the armor bag, picking up clips to get our grenades back anyway. It just seems like a good idea to have it. And I'm not going to do it. Either way, you could do either one of these. They can swap out, no problem. And then we're doing mag throw because since we have the ammo bag, it makes sense to just be able to give our teammates ammo so they don't can distinctively want to reach into your bag and take your charges. This is the main reason for this. Not really because we want to give them ammo, which really does help, but mostly to make sure that they don't reach in your bag. They have ammo. You give them ammo so they don't take your ammo. And then, of course, top up, just because we have the ammo bag and we want to refill all of our grenades. Then we're going with sprint loaded. I know I never use this one, but there's a method to my madness. Sprint loaded combined with the other reload perk, which we're going to get to, makes it so you can reload the grenade launcher faster. That's pretty much the only way to speed up the reload time of that grenade launcher. And you know that thing takes forever to put the grenades back in, because he does it super slow, one by one, racking them back in. This makes it faster and makes it so you can keep moving, so you don't have to stand still and wait for that to happen. Frugal thrower, yeah, we're doing that for the 20% chance that we might get a grenade back. Everything is all about the grenades. And then, of course, clean slate, just in case we do run out of all our ammo, we can pick up a repair pick kit to get one plate back so we don't have to actually drain our armor supply or our armor resources. We can leave those for our teammates. Last man, just in case you almost blow yourself up. I mean, it's a chance that if you're not doing this build exactly the way I'm telling you to do it, you might blow yourself up. This makes it so if that does happen, you're not immediately downing yourself or cutting your health to inches. This keeps you on your feet. And then, of course, to get that perk, we have to put on tank, which we actually want anyway, because that gives the 20% to that heavy ballistic armor that we're wearing, which slows it down quite dramatically. This makes it, you know, not much faster, but much better than if we didn't have it. After that, we're skipping everything in sharpshooter and we're getting escapist. This is when the build starts coming online. We're getting escapist because we need access to move and cover. Move and cover makes it so we can get grit on demand and we don't have to wait for a chunk of our armor to break to trigger grit. We can do it at any time we want. Basically, the way this works is, I have to tell you once I finish telling you the build, and then I'll tell you how it works. But either way, move and cover, just trust the process. And then of course, we're going disengage because we're going to be moving around away from our teammates because we don't want to cause any damage to them at all. And we're probably going to run straight into crowds and just clear things out without a care in the world, without taking any damage, hopefully. And the only thing that can really stop that really is cloakers and zappers, and we don't want them to get the chance to do that, so we're putting this on. After that, we're going to extra ammunitions because we want to have that max amount of throwables that we can have, so we're raising it from 3 to 5, and that's the maximum number we can get right now. But those 5 grenades seem to last really long no matter when you're throwing them. We're also doing overcooked. Absolutely, we want our throwables to explode instantly. We don't want that timer. The timer messes up the whole purpose. Then we're going with blast shield. Blast shield is how you tie this build all together. Like, again, I'll explain how it works at the end of it. Let's just get through all the skills first. Blast shield. And then 1 point into demolitionist. I remember I had this aced before, but I took it off because I'm going to get rushed no matter what anyway, just from running around. Then we're going into enforcer 1 point, and then this is the perk that I was telling you about. Quick reload with sprint loaded makes it so you can reload that heavy weapon or the overkill weapon, the grenade launcher, faster when you have edge and grit at the same time, which you get all the time with this build. You get all three of them all like over and over again pretty rapidly. And then of course combat reload to make sure that I'll explain it to you at the end. All of this ties together. I'm telling you, this build is really brilliant once you know how it works. It is a bit of a lot of micromanaging, but once you get the strategy of how it works and how the mechanics to trigger each thing whenever you want it to, then it's unstoppable. It's fun to me. After that, we skip manipulator. I know I told you we get menacing every round, which we do, and I'm probably gonna figure out how to put that in here, but as of right now, it's not on there. We're skipping engineer. We absolutely need at least 1 point to gunslinger, so when we swap, we instantly get edge. It's a part of the build, believe me, it makes sense. We're skipping gifter, we're skipping hacker, we're skipping tactician, which is a really good skill to have on this, but you don't need it to make this build work. We're skipping strategist, we're skipping CQC specialist, and we have transporter. And we're carrying two bags on this one, but man, I wish I could get this perk without having to add these two. But either way, transporter, deep pockets, power lifter, and then fortitude and pain needs to be in every one of your builds. It's mandatory. And then of course this one to round out our charges and our ammo back. But really I don't need that, and I can put that over here. And also really, I can take that off, and then that'll make it so we have manipulator as well. That's the build. We're gonna go ahead and jump right into gameplay and show you guys exactly how this works out. Believe me, I know you see these random assortment of perks and you're like, oh, that's terrible, that'll definitely work, that definitely won't work. But I'm telling you, once you see it in action, it 1000% works, and I promise you this would be probably one of the funnest builds that you play with, especially since they just added that throwable. I feel like this is going to be hilarious. It'll be funny with the throwable, but it's very deadly with the grenades. Just check it out. Let's go ahead and jump into gameplay, and I'll show you firsthand. Right, we got a random guy in here with us right now, and we're doing cook-off. Let's go ahead and do the normal weapon inspect. Looks pretty cool. We'll swap weapons. Oh, yeah. Look at that. That looks amazing. Alright, he's gonna do whatever he's gonna do. He's probably gonna set off the heist real fast. But anyway, the way that this particular... Fuck. Oh, we got a 125 in here. Okay. The way that this works is... you pretty much become invincible with throwing grenades. You don't take any damage. The way it works is you swap weapons to trigger your edge, and then once you have your edge, you climb up on anything to create a portal, which triggers the moving cover. Once you have a grit that you consumed your edge for, you can swap back. Look, you got both of them now. And if you run a little bit, you'll have all three. If you shoot, you can refresh that from combat reload. As long as you have those two and you climb up on something, swap. Look at that, all three. All right, now the way that this works is if you have edge and grit at the same time, then you trigger your shield blast. And because we have okay, hold on. Let me get somewhere real quick, y'all, before we lose all our hope trying to explain this to you. Alright, anyway. Oh, and we have that. That's beautiful. I love that high grain perk. But anyway, once you swap weapons, you trigger your gunslinger. Your gunslinger gives you edge. You can do this anytime you want and immediately get edge. Once you have that, you climb up on something to trigger your Once you have edge, you climb up on something to trigger your moving cover, which triggers your grit. Once you have grit, you go close to anyone, right? And throw that grenade directly at your feet. And because, but you have to have multiple enemies in front of you. If you have multiple enemies in front of you, it triggers your enforcer, which means that when you kill two enemies at a time, it absorbs the damage, so you don't take any damage at all. It makes more sense once I actually show you it in progress working. Alright, so let's find two enemies. Like, look at that. Find two enemies. When you reload, you refresh all of that. Look at that. That's not gonna work. We're gonna kill ourselves here. They're not grouping up for some reason. They're not grouping up! And I was running around outside like a dummy. I probably should have just waited for them to come in, but it doesn't really matter. So the minute I get up, one of them. Oh, he has one. Medic perks. The minute I get up, I'll do it again. Oh, he is. Hold on. I wish we had armor. They left this up here to burn.
That's one batch done. Right. Let's cook anyway.
Let's get that and then we'll climb. Okay. We'll do that. Alright, now y'all see where my health is at right now. When I run up to someone that's multiple, I won't take any damage when I throw this grenade. I have both, but it has to be at least two enemies. Like this right here is perfect. Look at that, no damage to me. Right, and you can literally just do that all game. Literally just do that all game and have endless grenades thrown. And then in case you do drop below, like how I just did it, your last man standing will drop. Now you need a health kit before you can get grit again, which actually stops your build completely. But any other time, you'd have a medic, or you could just go down and reset. We're gonna, all right, see, look, now that I went down, I'm getting picked back up. Now I can get grit again. Got it. All right, but anyway, if I was playing with an actual team, this would be exactly what I would do. Oh, and then they have armor here. Okay. All right, let's try it again. Look, now you can really see what's going on. If I, like, I grabbed three armor plates. And a med kit.
You're a natural. Ready for another bet?
Check it. All right. Now that I do that, we'll see. Oh, okay. This is even better. Okay. And that gave me my down back. Oh, look at that. Look how beautiful that is. All four of the procs together. Here. I heard them on this side. It must be over here. Yep. I wonder if I just throw a grenade at it, would it work? I don't know. Let's see.
Add hydrogen chloride to the mix.
I don't think that works. Yeah, I don't think that works, y'all. I think we gotta shoot it.
Forest.
get all our grenades back right here. Beautiful. The only bad thing about this track is if you aim down sights, you lose your edge. Then we climb up on something to trigger a grit, and then we once we trigger grit, that's a restart. Run straight up to the. Grit was consumed, so we didn't take any damage there. No damage there. Oh, I actually hit them through the wall right there. That was beautiful. Back away. Don't try it. I got the shield. The cops are bringing in the big guns. Joker's coming. Alright, we triggered it. We got all of them again. We can run up to them and throw grenades again. Beautiful, this is a perfect time. Look at that. No damage. Clear out a whole wave. No damage. I love it. We're gonna discharge right there. That's perfect for having discharge. Here's another one right here. That's only one. Bunch of them right here. We can do that again. No damage. Caustic soda. Beautiful. I'm feeling good about this. Wow, he has a whole bar of health right there. He must have picked up that one that was sitting down here. Alright, so now let's swap to get our edge. Climb up on something to get our grit. Now we got both again. This is a really great build. Really fun build. Look at this. No damage. That's the only downside to this build. This build does not help me kill that guy any faster. He can still be a problem. He could definitely still be a problem. But other than that, this is a really fun build. Y'all should definitely give it a try. I can't believe I was gonna die at the same time. But anyway, y'all should definitely give it a try. It's real fun. Bombardier, especially since that new global is coming out. Anyway, like, share, comment, subscribe. And if you see me online, give me a shout up if you need a game. Peace.